Call is now being recorded.
Okay, a very good afternoon to one and all. In the last lecture, as we are discussing about the verification, in the last lecture, we are discussing about the verification. So the verification that we are discussing about everything that we have to do, we have to verify it. That in the previous lecture, we are discussing about the goal and requirement of verification. Whether there are different points we are discussing in the goal and requirement of verification, like everything must be verified. The result of verification may not be binary. Then verification may be objective or subjective. Verification, even implicit quality must be verified. This is all we are discussing in the goal of verification. Now, in the verification, now we have to discussing about the testing. That is the very most important part of the SDLC, system development life cycle, is testing, is the verification, is the testing. Main objective of is what? The testing. So let's see that we are discussing about in today's lecture about the testing. So in the testing, we have to verify any piece of work is just to operate it in a some representative situation and verify whether its behavior is expected. What we are expecting? In our testing, we have to verify any piece of work, whatever we have to do in a software development, that software development that we have discussing is must be verified. Okay, I'm getting what I'm saying you. I'm saying is you that ki whatever the piece of work I'm doing for any kind of project, this piece of work is must be verified. We have to verify that piece of work, whether this work is behave like properly or not. In any situation, it is working properly or not. This all the things that we have to verify whenever we have to do any piece of work for our project. So for that piece of work, we have to necessary to find suitable test cases that provide enough evidences that desire behavior will be exhibited in all remaining cases. It is necessary to find suitable test case. Whenever we have to do the testing of our project, we have to do the testing. We have to do the testing in the piece of complete software testing, complete product testing is there, or it may be have a unit testing that from the modules we have to test it, and they add that module, the every program, every objective, every piece of work that I am going to test it. It is often difficult and sometimes it is impossible job to test the complete system at once. Definitely it is very difficult task, or it is sometimes even impossible that within a time we have test the complete work. So what we have to do it, we have to do, we have to test our product, we have to test our code in unit wise, in a module wise. Like here we can have, take an example of civil engineering product, civil engineering work, that is the bridge. Whenever we have to test the bridge, the first thing that we have to verify is the sustainable of that particular bridge. It means how much weight of this bridge is sustainable. Is I'm going to give that this bridge is sustainable is near about 1000 tons of weight, then as per our requirement, this bridge is must be verified. So like civil engineering product, we have to verify the bridge sustainable or ability to sustain the weight. Then only, as like as we have to verify our software product also, our software programs also, software modules also. Like I'm going to take an example of software that is a binary search.
that is binary search. In a data structure, there is an algorithm which is known as the binary search, which is having some own logic is there, while we can have the binary search. So whenever we have to apply our binary search algorithm to any kind of program, to any kind of software, so that binary search must be verified it. So this binary search algorithm is must be verified it, that we have to divide our searching elements in two parts, and then we have to search it by the middle left hand side and right hand side. That's the way we have to verify it, our binary search. So whenever we have to apply our binary search algorithm to any particular case, that binary search algorithm must be verified. It gives me the proper output or not. That verification must be there. That verification is nothing but the testing of our program. So let's we are discussing about the testing goals of testing. What are the main objectives? What are the main goals whenever we have to test our product? So one of the author, the famous Dijkstra algorithm, tells that the program testing can be used to show the presence of bugs, but never to show their absence. Have you seen the presentation that I'm going to show you? Goals of testing. It takes time because of the network. So now we can have the testing, the goal of testing. So the famous scientist tells that the program testing can be used to show the presence of bugs, but never to show their absence. Okay? Whenever we have to test our program, it shows me the bugs. It shows me the bugs, like here it is having the problem. Either it is a syntactical error or it is a logical error. But it never shows their absence. Okay? So, by using that goals, if the results delivered by the system are different from the expected one in just one case, this unequivocally show that the system is incorrect. Like, if I'm going to give you the example of binary search, in that binary search, I'm tested that binary search algorithm by 10 times. In that 10 times, 9 times the binary search algorithm gives me the correct output. But only one time it shows me the incorrect output. It doesn't mean that our program or our algorithm is incorrect. What? The 10 times we have to run the product, we have to test it, we have to binary search algorithm, we have to run the program 10 times. The nine times when I'm going to run the binary search algorithm, it gives me the correct result, but only one time it gives me the incorrect result. So it doesn't mean my algorithm, my binary search program that I have to apply it, it is incorrect. No, it is not incorrect. By contrast, if I'm going to take the contrast statement of it, so the behavior of a system, the behavior of a system on a finite number of cases does not guarantee correctness in a general case. Means what? If the 10 algorithms I'm going to test at only once times and it gives the correct result, it doesn't mean that the 10 algorithm is working correctly in future also. The two different things are there that I'm going to explain. The first one is what? The first one is what? The first one is that whenever I'm going to test any program 10 times, the finite number of times, and only one times the program, it doesn't give me the correct result, it doesn't mean that the program is incorrect. But in contrast, if I'm going to test the finite number of cases at only one times, so it doesn't give guarantee that the program is running completely. So that is how the goal of testing. We have to test our program in different condition, in different inputs, and in different ways. When only I'm going to say that the program is efficiency, is correctness, is good. Okay? We should simply keep in mind that no absolute certainty can be gained from a pure testing activity. On the other hand, absolute certainty can hardly be obtained on the basis of any human activity. I'm going to test a program. In that testing, we should simply keep in mind that no absolute certainty can be gained from a pure testing activity. Definitely, if I'm going to test any algorithm, any program at only once, it doesn't give me the absolute certainty. On the other hand, absolute certainty can be hardly be obtained on the basis of any human activity. Means we have to test that code in different situations. That only we can say that our program is tested correctly. Testing should be based on sound and systematic technique so that after testing, we may have a better understanding of product's reliability. Okay? There is a very important feature of software specification of software testing is reliability. What? The testing is should be based on sound and systematic technique. Okay? Whatever the technology, whatever the techniques that we have used to test our product, we have the sound knowledge of it. After testing, we may have a better understanding of the product reliability. That is only we have to give the advantage of reliability by using the sound knowledge and systematic testing of our product. Testing should help locate error, not just detect their presence. Okay? Testing doesn't show me the presence of error. It also locates the error. The result of testing should not be viewed as a simple providing a Boolean answer like yes or no to their question to whether software properly or not. Software testing that I am going to show you, it doesn't show their presence. It doesn't give me there is an error, yes or no. But it locates me the error, where the error it is, what kind of error is there in our program, it also gives. That means it is not only the binary operation or not only the Boolean answer is there, but it is also the descriptive answer. We have the debugging is there. We have to debug our code. Debugging means what? The step by step, we have to run our program. So that type of testing that we have to did it. So this testing is nothing but we have to debug our program. The next goal of testing, the testing should be repeatable. Means what? The test should be arranged in such a way that repeating of the same experiment, supplying the same input data to the same piece of code produce the same result. Is what? the testing should be repeatable. Means one code, we have to test the number of times, finite number of times, 10 times, 15 times. We have to give the input, supplying the same input to the program, to the same piece of code, and it, if it gives me the same output, the same result, then only we can have say that this complete product, this complete piece of block of code is tested properly. Are you getting what I'm saying? So the testing should be repeatable. Repeatable, it means what? The repeatable, it means that whatever the code we have to test it, that code must be executed the finite number of times, and we have to supply the same input at the 10 times by the same piece of code, and it gives me the same result, then only we can have say that the testing should be done. Finally, the testing should be accurate. The final goal is what? The testing should be accurate. Accurate means what? So the accurate, it will increase the reliability of testing. Whenever we have to perform a testing, this testing must be accurate. That means it increases the reliability. We have to reliable our product. So the accuracy of the testing activity is depends upon the software specification. What are the specifications we have given to our software? That specification must be accurate, and then our testing must be accurate. So these all are the goals of software testing is there. The next one is the theoretical foundation of testing. Next is what? The theoretical foundation of testing. Okay. The presence of an error or defect is demonstrated. Theoretical foundation, where we have to show the presence or defect in our system, in our program, that we have to verify. Here it is giving the example is there. For example, let P be a program. We are having the program whose name is P, and consider that D and R denote the input domain and its range respectively. Means if we are having a program which is name is P, and we are having the two two input domain are there. The D is there, and there is a one range of the program, that is R is there, D and R. So that is D is set of all data can be correctly supplied to the P. Means the D is the input domain, and we have to supply the correct input to our program P. And the results of P execution, if any elements of R, that means it is in the range. Means what? We are having the program name P. P is there. And the P program name is there. By applying the P program name, we have to input, the D input is there, the correct input that we have to provide it. And as a result of this, we have to give the properly range of the output is there. So both the D and R contain the sequence of data, and the P is a several input statement that we have to run it. Means what? We have to run that the P block of code by applying the input D, and it gives me the range of the output R. So that is how we can have the presence of error or defect is demonstrated. We have to demonstrate the error is there or any defect is there. If there is any error, if there is any defect is there, we have to answer it. We have to solve it, that particular error. A fault is an incorrect intermediate state that may be entered during the program. Definitely. A fault is what? The fault is an incorrect intermediate state. If we have to run any program, and in that any program, if there is any error, that error shows me there is a fault in our intermediate statement is there. So we have to find out the fault and execute the program. And the last one is what? The test case is an element. The test case is what? Any test case that we have to apply to any particular program code or any particular system. So that program code or any system is an element of test. Is what? Is elements of test. That testing must be theoretical foundation of it. We have to write it. Technical writer is there. If we have the job of tester, so the tester is having the test, the block of code, and there is a technical writer who writes the particular technicality about that code. So that is how the theoretical foundation of testing is there. The next one is the empirical testing principles and the testing in the small. So empirical testing principles is what? So in the empirical testing principles, the only testing of any system that can provide the absolute certainty about the correctness of system behavior is exhaustive testing. What is the empirical testing? Exhaustive testing is there. Means we have to test only the system that I'm going, that the system is providing me. The system is providing me only the correct result. That system I'm going to test in that empirical. That is the testing system under all possible circumstances. Means we have to test the system, we have to test the module, we have to test the program in any kind of situation, that any kind of situation, any input data is there, so then only we have to test our code. That is how the empirical testing is. So we have to apply some strategy in the testing. While we apply the empirical principles, there are exhaustive testing is there. In that exhaustive testing, we have to test only the correct code is there. Then there is a strategy of testing. Strategy means what? What kind of criteria we have to apply for the testing? That kind of criteria we have to apply is in the principle of the testing. So that is all about the empirical testing principle. And the last one is what? The testing in the small. So we have discussed this topic in the next lecture, because in that testing in the small, we can have the two different modules there. The first one is a white box testing, and the second one is a black box testing. So we have discussing this piece of code or this testing in small.